Do you want to live forever? Probably not. But you do want to feel strong, sharp, and capable for as long as possible. I'm Dr. Angela Mailis. And it's not just about adding years to your life, but adding life to your years. In my clinic, I treat people from their early adult years to their 60s, 70s, and beyond. Some stay active and independent, and others live with chronic pain, fatigue, or foggy thinking, and a growing list of medications. The difference? It often comes down to the habits they built years ago. The truth is, your 40s, 50s, and 60s are your window of opportunity. What you do during those years shapes how well you will age. Here are five rules to help you stay strong and why it's never too late to begin. Number one, move your body. Movement is life-saving. It supports your metabolism, controls blood sugar, protects joints, and helps your brain. But most importantly, muscles and balance prevent falls, one of the leading causes of disability and early death in older adults. Also remember, your bones weaken as you age, especially after menopause. A single hip fracture can change your life completely. Resistance training maintains bone density, preserves strength, and keeps you steady on your feet. Even light weights or body weight exercises are a good start. But your body must be challenged to improve. That's why progressive resistance training is essential. Number two, eat well to support strength and lower inflammation. Chronic inflammation is linked to pain, heart disease, diabetes, and dementia. Extra processed foods, sugar, and excess belly fat make it worse. A Mediterranean-style diet with more plants, healthy fats, and lean meats lowers inflammation and protects your body. As we lose muscle naturally with age, not enough protein speeds up decline. So aim to include quality protein in every meal. Eggs, fish, poultry, beans, and Greek yogurt, to name a few. It's the building blocks your muscles rely on. Number three, prioritize sleep. Poor sleep speeds up aging, drains your energy, weakens your immune system, and raises your risk of depression, pain, and disease. Most of us should aim for 7 to 8 hours. Same bedtime, fewer screens before bed. This is when your body repairs itself, and you need that repair to stay healthy. Number four, manage stress. Chronic stress raises cortisol and inflammation, and over time it wears you down. Find ways to reset. Breath work seen in meditation practices, journaling, prayer, or simply time in nature. These are not indulgences. They are necessary for a resilient body and mind. And also remember, friendship, community, and meaningful relationships can reduce stress, improve immune function, and even lower your risk of heart disease and dementia. Staying socially connected is one of the strongest predictors of long-term health. Make space for the people who uplift you. Whether it's sharing a walk, a laugh, or just a phone call, connection is medicine. Number five, know your numbers. Prevention is power. Track your blood pressure, cholesterol, and blood sugar. Over 50, stay on top of cancer screenings, bone density, and hormone health. Waiting for symptoms is waiting too long. We all age, but how we age depends on the choices we make now. So no, it's not about living forever. It's about staying sharp, strong, and mobile so you can keep doing what matters most. It's never too late. But the earlier you start, the more power you have. What is one small change you'll make this week? Your future self, 10, 20 or even 30 years from now will thank you. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe. We've got more episodes coming your way. See you in our next episode.